Alright, hello everyone, especially sa akong mga grade 10 students. So this time, kaninga video, ato ang ansiran ang isa sa mga word problems nga gihatag sa tua sa probability. Now, mo nitong problem, in a certain section, 25 students excel in academics, 20 excel in sports, and 25 excel in the performing arts. Inclusive in the given statistics are the students who excel in 2 or 3 of the said fields, such as 7 students excel in academics and sports, 14 in academics and performing arts, 10 both in sports and performing arts, and then 2 students are good at 3 fields. Now, we have questions as well. How many students excel in sports only? So, notice nun na nakabutang only. How many students excel in academics only? And so on and so forth. So, we will answer these questions as we go on how to illustrate and how to go about this problem. Now, we need to understand nga by reading the problem or the situation, no, kailangan ta magbuhat og Venn diagram para mas dali siya ma-answeran or ma-address ang mga parts regarding sa students, no, especially itong question ng number of students. So since Venn diagram ta, we'll be working with circles. So let's start making our first circle. The first circle will represent the students who are good at academics, right? And then, the second circle, let's say circle nga green o color, will represent the students who are good in sports. And the third circle will be the circle that will represent the students who are good in performing arts or who excel in performing arts. Now, you need to understand that the circles are intersecting tungod kay na-establish sa problem nga naay mga intersection, di ba? Kay naa may mga students nga maayo in 2 or more fields, right? So mo nang atong Venn diagram kaing ani, kay ato nang gi-expect nga mag-intersect ang mga circles or ang mga sets, no? Regarding sa set sa students nga good in academics, the set of students who are good in sports, and as well as in performing arts. So mo nang ani ang porma sa atong Venn diagram. Kay gi-expect na nato nga mo-intersect in sila. All right. Now, before we'll go on with the numbers, we need to understand the portions, no, the parts of the Venn diagram, di ba? So let's start off with this circle here, the circle representing academics. So kaning shaded region, mao ni siya ang represent sa mga students nga who are good in academics. So there might be students who are good in academics and as well as performing arts, mo ni nga part diri, right? So basta kay kanang shaded region, mao na siya ang mga students nga good in academics. Next, kaning circle, kaning green, which is of course nga gi-shaded og gray, no? This is the region that will represent those students who are good in sports. All right? Next, this shaded region will represent those students who are good or who are excelling in performing arts. All right? Particularly, kaning region, kaning shaded region, 'di ba kani siya kay mo ni siya ang intersection sa academics og sports. So that means kaninga region, kaninga shaded region, mo ni magrepresent sa mga estudyante who are good in both in academics and in sports. All right? And at the same time, kaninga shaded region, all right? Okay? Intersection sa performing arts nga circle og sa sports nga circle. Thus, this shaded region will represent the students who excel both in performing arts and in sports. And kaninga region will represent, no, the intersection of academics and performing arts. That is why kaninga shaded region will somehow house the students who are good in or who excel in both academics and performing arts. Now, this part here, kaninga shaded region, which is the intersection of 3 circles, klaro lang, mao na siya ang mag-house sa mga students nga who are good in 3 fields or in all of the fields in academics, sports, and performing arts. Right? So, na po tayo mga portion diri, ano, para mas klaro. So, kaninga portion diri, alright? Part di siya sa intersection sa academics o sa sports, right? But, walay labot ang katong maayos sa tulong fields. That is why, this shaded region will represent the students who excel both in academics and sports but not performing arts. Or in other words, we can say that this shaded region is or shows the number of students who are good in academics and sports only. Alright? Next, kaninga shaded region houses the students who excel in sports and performing arts only, or who are good in sports and performing arts but not academics. And finally, kaninga portion dire kay ang intersection di ba sa academics o sa performing arts walay labot ang sports. So therefore, this shaded region represents a student who excel both in academics and performing arts only. Right? Klaro. And as well as atong balikan, no? Kaninga portion diri which is not part of the intersections, all right? Kaninga shaded region diri will house the students who are good in academics only. Okay? As well as kaninga shaded region diri mao ni siya ang mga students nga who are good in sports only. All right? And this part here will house the students who are good in performing arts only. Right? So klaro na tong mga terms no nga only. Klaro na tong mga terms nga who are good in academics and performing arts but not sports. So mo na sila ang mga parts nga naa sa atong Venn diagram. All right. Right. Sige. This time atong ipakita ang mga numbers. Now let's go back to the problem. Right? Let's go back to the problem. So for us to really understand and for us to answer those questions posed earlier, ato sang ihinahinayon og butang ang mga numbers, no? Ang mga numbers nga ibutang sa kada parts sa ato ang Venn diagram. Now dito mo start diri sa 25 students excel in academics. Kay mo siya ang kuan, di ba? Ang 25 students excel in academics mo na siya ang totality sa mga students nga maayo academics. Appeal dira ang mga students nga maayo pud og sports daw maayo sa academics. All right? Such as 20 excellent sports and 25 excellent performing arts. So mo na nga ato na silang ibutang nga label sa ato ang mga Venn diagram. All right? So again, sa academics, no? Again, the whole academic circle, there are 25 students who are good at that. And sa sports pod, there are 20 students who are good at sports. Right? Again, there might be students who are good at sports and as well as academics, part na sila dali sa circle sa sports, right? And there are 25 students who are good in performing arts sa red na circle. So all the numbers that we will put here, no, should what they call this total to 25. All the numbers that we put here inside the blue circle should total to 25. And all the numbers that we put here that will be what they call this kanang masakop sa green na circle should equal to 20. All right? Sige. Now let's go back to the problem. So na ato nang nabutang, no? Again, ato nang nabutang ang 25, 20 og 25. All right? This time, ato na yung ibang butang ni ubang mga numbers sa tong Venn diagram. Now, ang technique dira you should always start kung asa ang pinaka-common sa tanan. So unsa to pinaka-common sa tanan? Ang ato sa tunga. So unsa ang number nga ato mabutang sa tunga? Of course, kaning two students are good at three fields. So kana sure na gid na wa nila ang kabutangan kundi sa tunga, right? Kay good at three fields man. So kaning portion diri this is the portion where the students who are good at all fields, sports, academics, and performing arts. So we put 2 there. Alright? Claro. Next. So after this, we'll have this part here. 10 students are good in sports and performing arts. So going back, asa to nga portion ang maayo sa sports and performing arts? Diba? Kaninga portion? Diba? So kaninga portion, 10 daw katao na dire. Since na may 2, diri therefore, ang naadri nga part is 8. Ayun. So once again, there are 10 students who excel both in sports and performing arts. Therefore, there are only 8 students who are good in or who excel in sports and performing arts only. Okay, gets ninyo nga nung 10 ha? 10 because 8 plus 2. Alright? Good. Next. Let's have this part here. 14 students excel in both academics and performing arts. So this is the portion where the students who are this is the portion where we can see the students who are good in academics and performing arts. Right? So it was said nga 14 daw kabuok since na may 2 diri therefore we have 12 students here. So once again, 14 excel in both in academics and performing arts. Therefore, there are 12 students who excel both in academics and performing arts only. Or in other words, 12 students who excel in academics and performing arts but not sports. Kaninga portion dire, right? Alright, next. This statement. Seven students excel both in academics and in sports. Again, both academics and sports. Yan. Seven daw kabuk na adira nga portion. Since na may two dire, therefore we have 5 students here. So once again, 7 students excel both in academics and sports. Therefore, 5 students excel in academics and sports but not performing arts. Yan. I hope you get the idea nganong unsa gayo sa pagkuha, no? Simple addition and subtraction lang, right? All right. Now, since we have filled up naman nga mga intersection, so let's go back to academics nga circle. So sa academics nga circle, there are 25 students who are supposed to be in it. Okay? Since na naman tayo 12, na naman tayo 2, na naman tayo 5, therefore, pila na kulang para may mag 25. There are 6 students, no? There are 6 students who are good in academics only. Kaninga portion din, right? Yun. Only 6 students who are good or who excel in academics only. Next, let's have the circle regarding sports. So there are supposedly 20 students who are good in sports or who excel in sports. Since we have 8, 2, and 5 already, so we have 10 and then 5, so we have 15. Therefore, we have 5 students who excel in sports only. There. So there are 5 students who excel in sports only. Get it? Good. And finally, sa performing arts na circle. Ayun. Since there are 25 students who are good in performing arts, and we already have 12 plus 2, that's 20, plus 8. 12 plus 8 is 20, so we have plus 2, so we have 22. Therefore, we only have 3. Yan, we have 3 students who excel in performing arts only. Ayan. Alright? All in all, so the question is, pila daw kabuka sudyante all in all, no? Sa isa ka section. So, ito lang i-add tanan. So, we have 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 12 plus 2 plus 8 plus 3. There are 40 students in that section. Alright? I hope nasabta ninyo and you will be prepared for probability questions or problems regarding this situation. See you around.